I'm happy to say that I've had a few major breakthroughs with regards to my lifelong fears around flying. They've never stopped me from flying, but they've definitely sucked a lot of energy out of me. But my last experience was completely different, and I just wanted to share how I was able to turn all that around. Much like the goals I set when moving through anxiety, depression, this year my intention was to work out how I can stay calm, confident, and at peace despite circumstance. Through burning out, I was able to see how much of my happiness and peace was hinged to how things ran, and it was exhausting because you put so much energy focusing on the things you can't control or you run from them. So with flying, the goal is to get to a point where, for the most part, I feel grounded despite what type of flight it is. Blue skies, black skies, storms, whatever. If I want a life of traveling, I can't spend the whole time on guard praying that it's going to be a smooth flight. If I know I can handle whatever comes my way, I won't waste energy worrying on approach and during. So here are some of the things that helped me. Build a strategy in advance by reflecting on your tendencies and set goals on how you want to feel rather than how you don't want to feel. Just like any strategy, you need to know where you are before you can work out how to get to where you want to go. I took time to reflect on my tendencies and habits, to which I discovered the same damn bad habits that stopped me from socializing and performing for all those years. Kind of a good thing, because it meant that the techniques I used to move through depression and anxiety would more or less help to dissolve the fears around flying. The goal: nothing is worth my confidence and peace. I want to know that I can stay grounded despite what happens around me, whether I'm happy about it or not. This is a place where anxiety does not exist. So here are some of the intentions I set based on my own habits and triggers. Everyone's will be different. These are just mine, and I'll give you some examples on how I use them. All right, number one, acceptance. You have to accept where you are. Now, this doesn't mean you like it or you're condoning it, but whatever you resist will persist. Again, that's where anxiety lies, and aversion spirals into this habit of running. So remember, I want to learn how to stay grounded with whatever happens. So during times where I felt a wave of fear or exhaustion or discomfort, I had to accept that that's the state I was in and not try to wish it wasn't so. It's only by accepting where we are at that we can make the best decision to bring us closer to where we want to be. Number two, thoughts, visions, beliefs. If you don't catch those bastards and you get swept up in the dialogue, you'll feel it in the body as an emotion and physical sensation, which will make those thoughts seem all the more real and warranted, to which like-minded thoughts will continue to generate. That's the cycle of anxiety. You have to be aware of what's happening inside. I had to deal with them way before the flight, because I knew that how I felt on the plane would be largely influenced by what I do and how I feel before it. I was like this thought ninja, pointing out every tiny little scary vision and returning my focus to whatever I was doing at the time, or responding appropriately to the persistent visions, which brings me to my next point. Three, have responses loaded. You need to have them loaded, ready to go, so you can fire back quickly before the spiral starts. Take some time in advance to imagine yourself in those situations, to work out what type of mantra or response you want to say to those negative visions and thoughts. And they also can be physical reactions, which brings me to my next point. Four, I want my posture to reflect how I want to feel. Even if it's not how I feel in the current moment, I worked out that I prefer to be uncomfortable feeling confident with a bring it on attitude than uncomfortable feeling like a victim. That's where anxiety also resides. So when I found myself feeling a wave of discomfort or anxiety, I was able to use my body to help it along by pulling my shoulders back and standing or sitting strong. It kind of made me feel like it was happening around me rather than to me, and much less consuming, sort of like pushing a weight at the gym. And just like the mind communicates to the body communicates to the mind. So having a confident posture helps to make the mind see that there isn't a threat, which in turn slows down the racing thoughts. Five, challenge the beliefs. Many of our fears come from all sorts of false, unchecked beliefs that have accumulated over the years, from past situations, skewered by how we've perceived it to happen, or the state that we were in when we experienced it. I really wanted to see how many of my beliefs were inaccurate so I could let them go. And my last point, humor. Lightening things up is such a great way to keep perspective, and it's pretty easy with Kenny as my co-passenger. Being serious all the time adds this extra unnecessary weight to a problem that actually isn't that serious. So taking the piss and laughing at yourself definitely helps to remind you that there isn't anything serious going on. And I also found humor to be the perfect segue in turning nerves into excitement. So that pretty much sums up the framework. I'm so stoked that the techniques that I use to get me through anxiety, depression have been beneficial when it comes to my fears around flying. There's more good that has come from me hitting rock bottom. Flying's never going to feel the same again. Thank you.